day one of listening to every Kidz Bop album and ranking them. First on the list is Kidz Bop. Released in 2000, this one's kind of stacked with bangers. Most of the songs are sang by adult vocalists, and the kids just come in for background vocals occasionally. Got some classics like Oops, I Did It Again, and I Want It That Way. It was a really wholesome listen, and honestly, I was pleasantly surprised by this one. I rank this one a solid 8.5 out of 10, straight bangers. Day 2 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next on the list is the very creatively named Kidz Bop 2. I don't know what happened with this one. The best tracks on here sound like kids' worship songs, and some of the production choices are just so strange. Their rendition of Turn Off the Light had me questioning some choices. If a time played low, if a tops go slow, and if it's full, then go. But the cover of Who Let the Dogs Out was kinda fun. Overall, pretty boring listen. I rate this one a 5 out of 10. Kidz Bop more like Mids Bop. I'm a survivor. I'm not gonna give up. I'm not gonna stop. I'm gonna work harder. Day 3 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next on the list is Kidz Bop Christmas 2002. I wasn't looking forward to this one, but honestly, they kind of popped off. You could honestly tell me the cover of Little Saint Nick was the original song and I'd believe you. And their version of Run Rudolph Run? Don't even get me started. Run, run, Rudolph, Santa's gotta make it to town. I usually hate Christmas music, but for some reason, it being sang by all kids makes it less annoying. Overall, I give this one a 7.5 out of 10. Pretty good. Day 4 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next, we got Kidz Bop 3. After the last two, I didn't know what to expect, but this one was so good. I genuinely like their cover of No Such Thing more than the original song. And hearing a bunch of kids singing In the End by Linkin Park is so strange. It's so hard and got so far. Overall, this one's definitely my favorite so far. I rate this one a 9 out of 10. I don't know what's wrong with me. Day 5 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next, we got Kidz Bop 4. Right off the bat, we're off to a great start with a cover of Skater Boy. But that was it. The rest of it sucked. I can't explain it, but the Ketchup song makes me unreasonably mad for some reason. Overall, this one's probably my least favorite so far. I give this one a 4 out of 10, slightly aggravating. Day 6 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next on the list, we got Kidz Bop 5. This one was pretty boring, but I didn't mind their cover of Hey Ya. It's kind of charming. Hey ya. Hey ya. And their version of Headstrong was okay. Overall, I can't even really blame them. I think the hit music in 2004 just kind of sucked. I rate this one a 5.5 out of 10. Meh. Day 7 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next on the list is Kidz Bop Gold. This one's a little spin-off they had with a bunch of hits from the 60s and 70s, and I gotta say, it's not too bad. The cover of Happy Together was honestly pretty nice. But their version of Hooked on a Feeling is so weird. For some reason, they chose to sing it in like a completely different key. Overall, I'm not really sure why this one had to exist, but it's alright. I give it a solid 5 out of 10. It's definitely music.
by me. Watch them now. Stay by me.
Day 8 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next on the list is Kidz Bop 6. This one's kind of crazy. They covered Toxic and didn't even change any of the lyrics. And they have some of the worst dance remixes I've ever heard. Overall, this one kind of felt like a fever dream. I rated a solid 2 out of 10, impressively bad. You are beautiful. Day 9 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop Halloween 2004. Kind of self-explanatory. This one's a bunch of Halloween songs. I already don't like the Monster Mash, and this version's just worse.
Did the mash.
He did the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
And their version of the Witch Doctor somehow sucked all the fun out of the original song. Overall, this one just sucked. I rated a 1 out of 10, not even spooky.
It was a one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
One-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
A one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater. Sure looks strange to me.
Day 10 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop 7. This one's got some bangers. I'm pretty sure their version of Let's Get It Started is the only version I even heard as a kid. And their cover of My Happy Ending, my god.
You are everything, everything that I wanted, that I wanted.
Overall, this one was pretty great. I rated a solid 9 out of 10.
Straight bangers.
I'll spread my wings and I'll learn how to fly. I'll do what it takes till I touch the sky. Make a wish, take a chance, take a change.
Day 11 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next on the list is Kidz Bop 8. This one was alright. Started off pretty strong with a cover of Since You've Been Gone.
Since you've been gone, I can't breathe for the first time.
And this might be a hot take, but I just don't like the song Take Me Out, and this version wasn't any better.
You say you don't know, I say, take me out.
Overall, this one was pretty forgettable. I rated a solid 6 out of 10, mids bop.
If I was a rich girl.
Day 12 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next on the list is A Very Merry Kidz Bop. This one was so boring. I had a hard time even picking out any snippets because nothing stood out. The Last Christmas cover was kinda good, I guess.
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart.
Overall, I did not enjoy this one. I rated a solid 3 out of 10. Absolute snooze fest. Day 13 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 9. This one was interesting. Their cover of Crazy Frog's Axel F was one of the strangest things I've ever heard. And their version of Feel Good Inc. was concerning. Overall, this one left me kind of speechless. I rated a solid 6 out of 10. You just got Weezer. Day 14 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is More Kidz Bop Gold. More old classics sang by kids for some reason. They covered ABC, which I thought was strange because it's already sang by kids.
ABC.
And after hearing their version of Girls Just Wanna Have Fun, I'm convinced they didn't listen back to some of these vocals. Overall, still not sure why they made this spinoff, but it wasn't the worst. I rated it a solid 4 out of 10. Tolerable.
Honey. Oh, sugar, sugar.
Day 15 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 10. A lot of boring songs came out in 2006. I feel like their version of Bad Day has the opposite effect of the original song.
Cause you had a bad day, you're taking one down, you sing a sad song just to turn it around.
And I guess they just didn't feel like actually censoring Pump It, because the kids just sing the ad-libs. Overall, this one wasn't that great, but it wasn't offensively bad. I rated a solid 5 out of 10. Mids bop. Day 16 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop 11. I think my music taste is breaking. Their version of Too Little Too Late was honestly pretty good. And their cover of Rush by Ali and AJ kind of just made it sound more like a Disney Channel intro.
Don't let nobody tell you your life is over. Be every color that you are.
Overall, this one wasn't too bad. I rated a solid 6.5 out of 10. Pretty good.
If I just lay here, would you lie with me and just fall?
Day 17 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop Country. It's bad. Who could guess? Their version of Jesus Take the Wheel made me feel like I was back in a church youth group.
Jesus take the wheel, take it from my hands.
And their version of What Hurts the Most was kind of heart-wrenching. Overall, I will say the kids' backing vocals do make these country songs a little more tolerable, but it's still not good. I rated a solid 3 out of 10. Yeehaw.
Life is a highway, I wanna ride it all night long, all night long.
Day 18 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next on the list is Kidz Bop 12. Started off with a cover of Girlfriend, which was pretty good. But hearing a bunch of kids singing How to Save a Life was a little strange.
Where did I go wrong? I lost a friend somewhere along in the bitterness.
Overall, this was one of the better albums so far. I rated a solid 7 out of 10. Pretty sweet. Day 19 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop 13. This one was stacked with bangers. Their cover of SOS by the Jonas Brothers had some interesting vocals.
We're texting sorry for the miscommunication.
Ooh, this is an SOS.
And I like their take on the questionable lyrics from Sean Kingston and Beautiful Girls. Overall, they kind of went off with this one. I rated a solid 9 out of 10. Absolute bangers. Day 20 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop 14. This one was wild. When I tell you the whiplash I got when I realized they had actual Sean Kingston on their version of Take You There. And their version of Clumsy sounded like they hired a newborn infant to sing. Overall, this one really caught me off guard. I rated a solid 7 out of 10. Please help me.
But how do you expect me to live alone with just me? Cause my world revolves around you, it's so hard for me to breathe.
Day 21 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 15. We've officially gotten to the ones with only kids' vocals. It's impossible to hear their version of American Boy without hearing the Fortnite version in my head.
It's the number one champion sound. Yeah, you know we're about to get down.
And did you know their version of Hot and Cold features a young Zendaya? Overall, I don't like where this is headed. I rated a solid 4 out of 10. Bring the adult singers back. Day 22 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 16. These are getting weird, but I gotta say, their version of Heartless is one of the best things I've ever heard. And their cover of Fire Burning was definitely something. My hips started wiggling, the way she danced around that girl got me wanna dance with her all night. Overall, this was a weird one. I rated it a solid 7 out of 10. In the end, it's still so lonely. In the night, I hear them talk, the coldest story ever told. Somewhere far along this road, he lost his soul to a girl so heartless. Day 23 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 17. I love the fake southern accents the kids try to do for Taylor Swift's You Belong With Me. Dreaming about the day when you wake up and find out what you're looking for has been here the whole time, if you could see. And their cover of Fireflies was kind of charming. I like to make myself believe that planet Earth turns slowly. Overall, I actually like this one. I rated it a solid 10 out of 10. They popped off. Day 24 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop 18. The album cover is kind of starting to suck. Their cover of California Girls by Katy Perry felt like a summer camp anthem. Sipping on the juice, laying underneath the palm trees. And the singers on Break Your Heart sound so bored. I'm only gonna break, break your heart. Overall, this one wasn't that memorable. I rated a solid 5 out of 10. Kidz Bop. I wanna be a billionaire, so very bad. Buy all of the things I never had. Day 25 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 19. A lot of good songs came out this year. Their cover of Dynamite wasn't that bad. Me and my crew. I'm in the club, so I'm gonna do. But it felt like they were pushing the limits of these kids' voices in their cover of Fireworks. Baby, you're a firework. Come on, show 'em what you're worth. Overall, this one wasn't too bad. I rated a solid 6 out of 10. Big mega radio smasher. Pretend that airplanes in the night sky are like shooting stars. I could really use a wish right now, wish right now, wish right now. Day 26 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop 20. Let me tell you, I was eager to hear how they changed the lyrics to The Lazy Song by Bruno Mars. The ex need a really nice girl, send a really nice text, and she's gonna write back, you're so great. Oh my god, you're so great. And honestly, the kids' vocals for Rolling in the Deep were pretty good. There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. Overall, this one was pretty decent. I rated a 7 out of 10. Pretty good. Day 27 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up, we got Kidz Bop 21. This one was stacked with party songs. I was really looking forward to their cover of Party Rock Anthem, and it wasn't that bad. Party Rock. And I kind of prefer their version of Stereo Hearts over hearing Adam Levine sing. Overall, this album makes me want to party. I rate it a solid 7.5 out of 10. Party Rock is in the house. Bring me up, bring me down, playing sweet, make me move to the beat. Day 28 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 22. I gotta say, their cover of Starships had some really good censorship.
We can't stop. We're Kidz Bop and we take over.
And finally, they covered the best pop song ever made, Call Me Maybe.
Hey, I just met you.
Overall, I don't know what's happening, but these albums are getting better. I rated a solid 8.5 out of 10. Absolute bangers.
I'm not a payphone trying to call home. All of my change I spent on you.
Day 29 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 23. This one has Gangnam Style. And I was surprised to hear the kids actually sing it in Korean. But hearing the song Good Time without Owl City or Carly Rae's vocals kinda made me hate it. Overall, this one was a mixed bag. I rated a solid 6 out of 10. It's decent. Day 30 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 24. Their version of Thrift Shop is one of the worst things I've ever heard.
Walk up to the club like, what up, I got a hit song.
I'm so pumped about some clothes from the thrift shop.
But their cover of I Love It had a pretty iconic moment.
You're from the 70s, but I'm a Kidz Bop kid. I love it!
Overall, this had some of the best and some of the worst so far. I rate this one a solid 7 out of 10.
The joke is on me.
Hey!
I knew you were in trouble when you walked in.
Day 31 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 25.
Oh boy.
If you ever wondered what sound a fox makes, but wanted to make sure it was kid friendly too, Kidz Bop's got you covered. And this might be a little controversial, but I do not like Pitch Perfect, and their version of the cup song is even worse than the movie's version. Overall, I did not like this one. I rated a solid 3 out of 10. Annoyingly bad. Day 32 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 26.
Some pretty good lyric changes on this one.
Honestly, props to the writers. They had to basically rewrite Pitbull's entire verse on Timber.
Money and fame club, Gemini, Kidz Bop now.
Yeah!
Dance with me, we're going round the home.
And their cover of Counting Stars has probably one of the lamest lyric changes yet. Overall, I can't help but be impressed. I rated a solid 7 out of 10. Pretty freaking good.
Ain't it fun?
Day 33 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 27.
We are in deep.
This one had one of the worst pop songs ever made, All About That Bass.
I'm all about that bass, about that bass, no trouble.
But I honestly really liked their cover of Cool Kids. Overall, not the worst. I rated a solid 6 out of 10. I'm getting tired. Day 34 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 28. I honestly could not stop laughing when I heard their censored version of Uptown Funk.
Stop. Wait a minute. Fill my cup, put some water in.
And their version of Blank Space isn't that bad, but their choice of lyrics kind of ruined the flow. Overall, this one was kind of weird. I rated a solid 6.5 out of 10. Guys, I'm getting so tired of listening to Kidz. Day 35 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 29. I don't know what happened with their cover of GDFR by Flo Rida, but something's just off.
It's going down for real.
But honestly, their cover of Shut Up and Dance With Me kinda goes insane.
I said you're holding back. She said shut up and dance with me.
Overall, this one was decent. I rated it a solid 7 out of 10.
The kids are getting good.
Day 36 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 30.
I'm noticing that Taylor Swift songs work really well, Kidz Bop.
Their version of Bad Blood is pretty spot on. But their cover of Watch Me Whip was... Oh.
Not good.
Overall, this one had some of my least favorite pop songs. I rated a solid 4 out of 10.
Even the kids couldn't have saved 2015.
Day 37 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 31.
This one had a Hotline Bling,
and their lyric changes made the song pretty wholesome.
So call me on my cell phone anytime you need to talk.
And their lyrics for Justin Bieber's What Do You Mean almost sound like a parody.
When you sometimes say yes, but you sometimes say no, what do you mean?
Overall, I quite liked this one. I rated a solid 8 out of 10. This one is a Kidz Bop.
Hello from the other side. I must have called a thousand times.
Day 38 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Took a slight detour and went back to listen to Kidz Bop Sings the Beatles.
Yep.
Hey, those kids really put their heart and soul into Here Comes the Sun.
Here comes the sun.
An Octopus's Garden kind of sounds like it was meant to be sang by small children.
I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden.
Overall, this was definitely kids singing Beatles songs. I rated a solid 5 out of 10,
better than the originals.
Day 39 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 32.
Uh-huh.
Kinda grossed out that they covered Cake by the Ocean without changing literally anything.
I keep on walking with Cake by the Ocean. Oh.
And I gotta say, the song My House is just not the same without Flo Rida.
Welcome to my house, come on, take control now.
Overall, few hiccups, but this one wasn't bad. I rated a solid 6 out of 10.
Definitely the 32nd Kidz Bop album.
Day 40 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 33.
I'm noticing a decline,
and Kidz Bop keeps reminding me how much I hate Meghan Trainor's music.
If I was you,
I'd wanna be me too.
I'd wanna be me too.
And I swear their version of Can't Stop the Feeling sounds exactly like the original. Bad. Overall, I didn't like this one. I rated a solid 3 out of 10.
These are getting boring.
Day 41 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 34.
This had all the pop songs I forgot existed.
Except 24K Magic. Even Kidz Bop, it's still a banger.
Kidz Bop, it's showtime.
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 Guess who's back again?
Oh, they don't know.
Concept.
Oh, they don't know.
Concept.
I bet they know as soon as we walk in.
And once again, I prefer the kids' vocals to Adam Levine's voice in their cover of Don't Wanna Know.
No, no, no. I don't wanna know.
Overall, this one was all right. I rated a solid 5 out of 10.
Kidz Bop.
Don't you give up? Nah, nah, nah. I won't give up. Nah, nah, nah. Let me love you. Let me love you.
Day 42 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 35.
I had never listened to the radio in 2016, so I didn't recognize most of these songs.
But I did remember That's What I Like by Bruno Mars, and their version was kind of funny.
Strawberry milkshake. For you, that's what I like, that's what I like.
But of course, the blandest pop song in existence, Stay by Zedd, sounds exactly the same.
All you have to do is stay a minute, just take your time, the clock is ticking, so stay.
Overall, not much I liked on this one. I rated a solid 1 out of 10.
2016 just sucked.
Day 43 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 36. This one went kind of crazy. Their cover of Congratulations had to be one of the hardest Kidz Bop songs yet.
For the money, I'm a savage. Yeah, I be itching, gotta have it. Yeah.
And Juju on that beat comes in as a close second.
And I'm a Kidz Bop kid. And I don't know nothing else besides dancing and having parties and having some fun.
Overall, I think the kids were trying to prove something on this one. I read it a solid 8 out of 10. They made me a believer. Day 44 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 37.
I hate Imagine Dragons,
and I don't appreciate Kidz Bop reminding me with their cover of Thunder.
Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer.
And while I don't like the song Havana, it did get me to appreciate the vocal range of these kids. Overall, this one wasn't bad. I rated a solid 6.5 out of 10. Yeah.
Ooh, look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me do.
Day 45 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 38. This one has God's plan. And I can't help but picture all the Christian moms singing along to this one.
She said, do you love me? I tell her only partly.
I only love my bed and my mom, I'm sorry.
And they had some pretty good lyric changes on their cover of mine.
We go from way back in, it's so wild.
Overall, this was one of the most interesting ones in a while. I rated a solid 8 out of 10. Day 46 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 39.
I need a Kidz Bop rap album.
Their cover of Drake's In My Feelings has one of my favorite Kidz Bop moments so far.
Yeah, KB baby.
I bought you stuff that costs more than a penny.
And I think their cover of High Hopes proves it's not Brendan Urie's voice that makes it annoying. Overall, not horrible. I rated a solid 6 out of 10. We're getting so close to the end.
I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. This is me.
Day 47 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 40.
Oh my god, this one is so long.
Because this one has 66 songs, this is going to be part 1 of 3 for this album. But I finally got to hear one of my most anticipated covers, Old Town Road.
Riding on a tractor.
And their cover of Sunflower really made me appreciate Swae Lee's vocals.
Things are all bad, bad, nevertheless. Yeah. Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck.
Overall, first third of this album wasn't bad. I read it a solid 6 out of 10. Stay tuned for part 2. Day 48 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. This is part 2 of the massive 66-song album, Kidz Bop 40. In case you thought Lucid Dreams was safe from Kidz Bop, they ruined that one too.
It's to the point where I love and I miss you and I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Oh.
And I think their cover of Someone You Loved is one of the most dramatic Kidz Bop songs I've heard.
I was getting kinda used to being someone you love.
Overall, the middle section of this album wasn't very good. I rated a solid 4 out of 10. Stay tuned for part 3. Day 49 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. This is part 3 of the massive 66-song album, Kidz Bop 40.
Woo!
I think their cover of Hey Look Ma, I Made It is one of the few times where I missed Brendan Urie's voice. And in their cover of Just Got Paid, I'm realizing my favorite moments are when they just yell Kidz Bop. Overall, this last section was not amazing. I rated a solid 3 out of 10, and after averaging out the past two parts, this whole album comes out to a 4.3 out of 10. A little bloated.
We're just here to say happy birthday. 24 hours to celebrate.
Day 50 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. So it's really what I'm doing. That's what I'm doing with my time. Next up is Kidz Bop 2021. This one had 44 songs, but honestly, I only hated one of them. Dance Monkey. But yo, they kind of went off with their cover of Blinding Lights.
No, I can't sleep 'cause it's gonna think too much.
Overall, for being this big of an album, all the covers were pretty good. I rated a solid 8 out of 10. Those last 2 points are for Dance Monkey. Day 51 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them. Next up is Kidz Bop 2022. This is the second to last one, and it was kind of stacked. When I started this series, there was one cover in particular I was always looking forward to, Montero. And I'm not sure why there's a 2016 song on here, but they covered Goosebumps. Overall, this one was kind of iconic. I rated a solid 7 out of 10, only one more album. Day 52 of listening to every Kidz Bop album and rating them.
This is it, guys.
We've made it to the final album in the series,
Kidz Bop 2023. Can't believe we did it.
And right off the bat, they came in with one of their best lyric changes yet on their cover of About Damn Time. But honestly, I don't know if I could forgive them for what they did to Steve Lacy's mega hit, Bad Habit. I bite my tongue, it's a bad habit. Overall, this one had a lot of ups and downs. I rated a solid 5 out of 10, and that marks the end of an era.
Except for the album tier list I'm gonna put up on